Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Over the past few days, a giant swarm of locusts have flown all the way across the Arabian Sea from Africa and have landed in India and have started destroying crops. These insects are some of the most fast-moving destroyer of crops, some of the biggest international pests, and have already started creating mayhem in multiple states, starting with Rajasthan. These insects are extremely devastating and threaten agriculture in many countries around the world. Let's take a deeper look at locusts and the plagues that they have brought upon humanity. Locusts are grasshoppers. There isn't any distinction between the two. There's no difference in their classification. But grasshoppers are called locusts when their behavior changes. Grasshoppers are solitary creatures, but when their population increases in an area, when the population density increases, they start becoming gregarious. In ecology, gregariousness is the tendency of animals to form social groups and hunt or attack or eat together. So, gregarious hoppers tend to form swarms and then are called locusts. Locust swarms are of three types depending on their population density. Small pockets of swarming is called an outbreak and happens in a very localized area. Larger groups are called an upsurge and they are also geographically confined. When large, giant groups of locusts separated by different breeding locations all swarm together in huge numbers, they are called plagues. Gregariousness, or the tendency to swarm, is caused by weirdly when locusts keep touching each other on their hind legs. As population density increases, typically due to shortage of food or a drought, this kind of physical contact increases as locusts come together. The constant hind leg touching and tickling releases a large amount of the neurotransmitter serotonin. This serotonin is one of our happy hormones and it's also released in our bodies when we exercise and it regulates our mood. When locusts are touching each other, there is a huge serotonin buildup in their bodies, in the locusts whose hind legs are stimulated. Experiments have shown that this can occur in as few as 10 locusts if they're really tightly packed. When they swarm, they tend to adopt aligned movement and they fly or march collectively. Nymphs, which are the flightless young of the locust, march, and when they sprout wings, they fly. Gregariousness also induces physiological changes where locusts change color as well, becoming the typical yellow-brown color that we associate with locusts, changing from the green grasshopper color. All of these changes are caused or are induced by serotonin. Large swarms of locusts can contain crores or billions of individuals, and locusts can fly up to 200 kilometers a day, destroying all food crops and all kinds of greenery in their path. An adult locust can eat up to 2 kilograms of food in a day. It can eat its own body weight, and a 1 by 1 kilometer swarm can eat the same amount of food as 35,000 people can eat at one go. The swarm that's currently attacking Indian crops has its root in heavy cyclones and rainfall of 2018, 2 years ago. The species that is attacking now is the desert locust, which typically lives in the Arabian Peninsula in arid regions in West Africa. Back in 2018, there were heavy rains and cyclones. In the Horn of Africa, there was a lot of flooding. Many countries like Kenya, Ethiopia, and Somalia were flooded right after a very severe drought the previous year in 2017. For the locusts, though, the conditions were extremely favorable. They were wet and they were very favorable for breeding. The locusts bred through 3 generations. Locusts always breed exponentially. One female can lay anywhere from 30 to 50 to even 100 eggs. So by early 2019, the locust population in the Horn of Africa region had already reached swarm levels. They took flight from Africa and they moved into Iran, Yemen, and Saudi Arabia. Their flight or migration is also aided by wind and they tend to move with the wind flow. Then more swarms formed in these new areas and then they spread to even up to Pakistan, where they devastated the cotton economy. And then they even flew back to Africa in the spring of 2019. Finally, in 2020, this year, they flew all the way across the Arabian Sea and landed in Rajasthan, swiftly moving into the country in just this week. Locusts have been known through history. They've even been recorded in biblical times. The oldest record dates back to Egypt, back to almost 2500 BCE, depicted on tombs, in Egyptian tombs. In the Bible, they've occurred near about 1450 BCE. They're also mentioned in the Quran and other religious and holy books in this region. They've been recorded in ancient China. They've also been recorded in Greece, in Rome, in Syria, and many other regions. Recently, in the 19th century, a species of hopper known as the Rocky Mountain locust devastated the United States. In 1875, a giant swarm formed, consisting of over what is estimated to be 12 trillion individual insects, weighing lakhs of tons and spanning an area that is thought to be 510,000 square kilometers. This swarm was bigger in area than Maharashtra and Karnataka put together. In the US, the swarm was larger than the size of the state of California. When these swarms flew, they blacked out the skies over multiple states like Colorado and Nebraska and ate everything green that they could see. They ate more than just green. They ate wool off sheep's backs. They ate harnesses off horses' backs. They ate wooden handles on tools and equipment, especially farming equipment. They even ate the clothes that people were wearing on their backs. This deadly swarm was the largest gathering of any animal ever recorded. Locusts for 4 years, from 1873 to 1877, destroyed farmlands in America. People, of course, went crazy. There was a lot of economic loss and there was a lot of farmland loss. After a point, government started introducing bounties for killing locusts. Farmers started digging pits and burning them with flamethrowers. There were makeshift weapons made of fabric doused in oil, and then entire farmlands were set on fire. People even started eating them. Grasshoppers and locusts are in fact a delicacy and some of the most nutritious edible insects, with thrice the amount of protein than any other kinds of protein-rich meat. Of course, it's no longer considered safe to consume locusts in most parts of the world because they're full of pesticides and are highly toxic. But no matter what people did back in America, the locusts continued to destroy crops and livelihood for several years. And then eventually the locust population reduced, and within 20 years, they disappeared. The Rocky Mountain locust went extinct. In fact, this was the first pest that was driven to extinction, and we don't still fully understand why and what was the driving force behind the species going extinct. It is considered to be the biggest ecological mystery. The last individual of this Rocky Mountain locust species was seen in 1902. There are theories, of course. Apart from direct intervention, it is thought that the widespread mining and digging the ground to plant more resilient crops brought up hundreds and thousands of eggs. Early technological development in agriculture, such as the use of plowing and irrigation, is thought to have driven the pest to extinction by killing all these nests of eggs that were buried underground and in the soil. Today, North America and Antarctica are the only two continents on this globe that do not have locusts. Swarms of locusts have destroyed lakhs of crores of rupees worth damage to crops and economy throughout the globe throughout history. But unlike the biblical times or the Rocky Mountain times, or even unlike just 50 years ago, today we have the knowledge and technology to control these swarms. Swarms are exacerbated by climate conditions caused by global heating. That's the root cause for most disasters today. Farmers have also switched to crops that can be harvested much before locusts come. But the locusts themselves can also be controlled or killed with pesticides. Monitoring for locust breeding is important. It's much easier to destroy eggs in the soil than fully grown locusts that have already taken flight. And additionally, a newer promising technology that has worked in laboratory settings is inhibiting serotonin. We do this in human bodies in the form of antidepressants. Prozac, for example, the most famous drug that a lot of people know about, is a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, which means that it works by blocking the absorption of serotonin in the brain. The same can be scaled up and used for locusts as well, especially among large populations, in a preventive manner. This has shown to be effective in the lab. Meanwhile, it is important for vulnerable countries in Asia and Africa to closely monitor locusts and prepare for such invasions. Today, these kind of swarms are fairly rare, but they do happen once in a while, like right now. This is Sandhya Ramesh from Bengaluru for The Print.